Hello, everybody. That's right. It's time for more attention deficit gaming. Here in Sector Brenia. Brunia? Whatever it is. Here, things are pretty soggy.
Uploading data.
The lower levels of Brenia are mostly submerged. You will need your gravity suit to operate there at full efficiency.
No kidding.
Abilities such as the grapple beam or space jump will help you maneuver underwater to an extent. Find them as soon as possible.
I kind of figured I was going to need the grapple beam. But that's based on what all those blocks that I assume... No. That's new. I need energy, not missiles! A bit more like it. That's gotta be for the storm missile. Huh. Oh! How did I miss this spider magnet for the ceiling? You need the space jump when you can use the spider magnet. Ha! Like a boss! Yeah, I'm gonna need the speed booster for that. Or space jump. Either one will work. Let's see what else we got here. Okay, so it's a save room. Is it safe? don't think so. Huh. I don't like the looks of that thing, and it looks kind of armored, so... What the heck were those? Wait, that thing was like a swimming grapple point, wasn't it? Maybe. So what's in here? Yeah, like it's actually gonna be that easy. The last item cube I got required me to defeat a boss. Combat Aeon ability that allows humans to instantly move forward or backward a set distance with full Aeon. Hold A to prepare a flash shift. Next, tilt L forward or backward to move instantly in that direction. Alternately, press A while moving with L. This ability can be used in midair as well. Samus can perform up to two additional flash shifts by holding down A and tilting L forward or backward immediately after the first flash shift. Let's see. It'll consume the full Aeon gauge. Additional flash shifts consume no further Aeon. Oops. That's definitely a cool ability. Not sure how I'm supposed to make use of it, though. That's green, so it means I need the super missile. Green blast shields always require the super missile. Dick! Crap! Let's try that again. Remembered something. In Super Metroid, there was an enemy that just kind of flew back and forth that you could actually grapple onto. So I guess that's kind of what those funky looking fish are. Okay. I didn't know better, and I honestly might not in this case. Come on! The heck? Oh, wait, that was just supposed to lower the water level, wasn't it? This goes. Yeah, the gate for that shuttle kind of looks like the kind of looks like a Stargate when it's active. Pretty cool. Well, I think it is. Try that again! There! There we go. Let's hope it's not waterproof. It's not. It is. Crap! Screw you, EMMI! Freaking hate this EMMI. You can't outrun the darn thing because it's got the freaking speed boost. Thank you. Dang it! Last resort measure of... Kidding. Wait, why the heck didn't I just use the flash shift? Yeah, flash shift. Like a flash step, really. Nothing this way. Okay. Bleh. It's another daughter brain down. Which means we're about to have another EMMI. Gotta be kidding me. How the heck am I supposed to melt its faceplate off if it just uses the speed booster to close the distance? What the freaking crap? Of course, timing that is practically impossible. Come on! it looks like the timing for it is random too. So you have to actually react. Got the faceplate off that time. Seriously? And the Emmy Award for most rage-inducing enemy is... this yellow asshole. How am I actually doing worse? Yeah, if I were to give this game a review, I'd take an entire point off just for this one Emmy. There is no room for error with this dang thing. Yeah, I'd go track it down here with the painting. Hey! I actually did it! Seriously? Correction, 2 points off. Well, I think I know how to melt its freaking base plate off now. I'm getting there. Well, the buzzer just went off, so as always, folks, do not stop being awesome, and I will catch you in the next video. But until then, take care.